Welcome back everyone to the lecture about applied bioimage analysis. This part is about NIME image processing, and I got some slides from Stefan Helfrich, who works at NIME as Academic Alliance Manager. Thank you, Stefan. So NIME is a tool for data analysis and visualization and getting something out of data in general. And it follows a graphical programming paradigm. I will show you a bit more in detail. So NIME is kind of a big universe where you have a lot of processing opportunities for any kind of data. So text mining, network analysis, image analysis. It's really a huge thing. So NIME uses also so-called workflows, basically the same term we also use. Here you also see how they work. So you have workflows consist of nodes, and you see here that a node is this. I mean, a node is basically this colored box which have inputs and outputs, and then it also has here this crossing light symbol which tells you the state of this particular node. I will come back to this a bit more in detail. And depending on what goes in and what goes out and how you plug all these nodes into each other, you may at the end have a workflow like this. You on the left side input some data, and on the right side you get hopefully insights out. And there is, dependent on what you want to do with data, there's different categories in NIME. I mean, first of all, of course, you have kind of data access nodes, so nodes which allow you to import, to load data, to access it, right? And then often you have to transform data from one shape to another. So maybe you work with text files, but you have to transform them into tables. And then maybe in a table you want to make rows out of columns. So stuff like that is transformation of data. Then there is analysis and data mining stuff. So you could basically think of image analysis in this category. At the end, you want to visualize what you analyzed out of your data. So you want to plot things, or you maybe want to draw a contour around an object you found. And then last but not least, you want to save the data somewhere, or you want to upload it to a server, you want to deploy it or export all the data in some way that you can later on access it again in a different software or the same software as easy as possible. This is how the NIME software basically looks like. At the beginning, it's like, wow, so many windows, but it's actually quite easy. So you have in the middle, you have your so-called workflow editor. You start, I show you later, you start basically with a white area. And then you can, from the node repository here on the bottom left, you can drop nodes into your workflow. What's also very helpful, actually, especially for beginners, is the NIME Explorer, which allows you to go through pre-existing workflows, which either come with the software to your hard drive or which exist somewhere in the internet. And you can just search for a term, like you want to do image segmentation or something like that. And then it gives you example workflows doing image segmentation. That's actually quite practical when it comes to learning. Then there are some more windows, for example, here on the right, giving you some documentation. But I honestly don't, for example, use the console so much. NIME image processing is actually kind of a separate thing, a plugin for NIME, let's say. So NIME image processing uses some capabilities also from the ImageJ universe, actually, to provide image analysis and image processing nodes to the NIME software. This is how the company, or how the NIME community, divides several parts of their software and also kind of clearly wants to communicate what is open source and what is a community thing and what is a company thing. So you see here, as you see in NIME, actually a nice example of how these two things can go together. For example, ImageJ Fiji is a fully open source thing. NIME is divided into two parts. So you have on the one side, you have NIME server and also the partner extensions. Yeah, imagine NIME, the company, collaborates with a partner. They work together on a project. They want to analyze something out of data nobody else has done before. Of course, this may not be open source. And of course, they want to keep them for themselves and maybe sell services based on that. But you have on the other side, the NIME analytics platform and the community extensions we will be using today. You have open source parts which everyone can access. And NIME is a software you can just download. So it's different from a purely open source thing, but it's actually a nice example of how a company and an open source project can go well together. Then in the NIME ecosystem, or basically in software in general, right, interoperability is an important thing. And the NIME developers took that quite serious. You can from NIME access ImageJ, you can access Fail Profiler, you can use famous plugins TrackMate. We will have a look at that maybe in 3 weeks approximately. You can also have a look at Clear Volume, for example. You can access plugins or other softwares from within NIME. So NIME is basically a tool to integrate tools from other tools, and that's actually quite practical. So yeah, as I said it already initially, NIME is built on the concept of nodes and workflows. And furthermore, a core concept is that they use basically tables. You see here a very minimalistic workflow. So I have on the left side, I create a table, just as an ImageJ, as in Excel, wherever. I do something with this table here. In this case, I call a group by command, whatever group by means. Yeah? So I do something with this table and then I save it to disk. So I have these three processing steps and you see that they have a different status. And when I execute this workflow, afterwards they are all green. So this is basically, that's what we want to do. So when you build your workflow, it will somehow look like this. And then you have to bring it to the point where all the lights are green. And the idea behind, or what you have to know about these lights, is when a node is green, that means that the node was executed properly, everything is done, and green light, right? Yellow means that the node wasn't executed yet, but it's, in principle, it's okay. It could just be executed. If there is an exclamation mark in a yellow triangle, this node tells you that it wants to be configured, so it doesn't know what to do. And this is how it tells you. And if it is a red light but no exclamation mark, it means somewhere on the left there is a node which has an issue. This one might be executable, but it cannot because a node in advance of the workflow wasn't configured yet correctly. And this is what I mentioned as a concept of table. So basically, all inputs into nodes are tables, and all outputs are tables. And there are, of course, tables with numbers. And there can also be tables with images. And sometimes you have a table which has a single row, a single column containing just an image. So this is basically an image, but as in NIME, everything is kind of handled as tables. You find it somehow like this. So the installation of NIME is actually not too complicated. You just download it from the website. And then afterwards you go to the Help Install New Software menu. And you have in this window, which pops up, you have to select here the community contributions. And within the community contributions, you select image processing and analysis. Because some students were struggling last year with the installation of NIME, let me show you today in more detail how the installation works. So this is basically it. You come to an empty workflow in NIME and image analysis stuff installed. And for who this was too fast, the full video is in the slides which you can download from the internet. All right, so let's try out NIME. So what we want to do, we want to again open the blobs.gif image. We want to apply a median filter for it for denoising. We want to apply a thresholding to it, a connected components analysis, and then we want to measure the objects found in this particular image. I would start with putting all these individual operations into a workflow sheet. And then we just start from the left to the right, from the beginning to the end. So when we want to open an image, if we want to load data, we can search here the node repository for load. So let's see how this goes. So for load, obviously, we cannot find an operation for images. So let's try open as well. And you will see also open does not contain the thing we are looking for. So we continue and we search for read, for example. And reading is obviously the thing. And most of the nodes, or actually all of them, I believe, which are relevant for the workflow today, we will find in the community nodes here in the image processing category, right? So the image reader is obviously the node I'm searching for. Then the next step was a median filter. So let's enter median, and you see, again, in the community nodes, NIME image processing, there is a median filter, and we use this one. And to understand how Naive nodes, I mean, how a Naive workflow is built, I will, with this very, very tiny, very small workflow, just show you how you can do things. So first of all, we have now our nodes. You can connect them by drawing a line from the outputs from one node to the input to another node. Furthermore, you see here the exclamation marks telling us there's something wrong with this particular node, and also tells us no files are selected. Yes, we haven't told the node yet which file to open. And we can tell the node things by configuring it. So I press the right mouse button here, and I click on configure. And sometimes this dialog looks a bit screwed up, like at the moment. And you can fix that by just changing its size for a second. And now you see this is how it's supposed to look like. And now you can see here I have my folder with my three images, and I can add the selected file to the list of files which will be opened. So that also means I can, with this dialog, with the image reader, I can open multiple files at once. So the problem of programming a for loop which processes all images is gone from the very beginning. Like in CellProfiler, it's thought for processing many things and not individual images. So, but I will now, for building the workflow, I will just select this one individual image. And you see now here it's yellow, so it means it can be executed, but it wasn't executed yet. If I execute it, so this is by pressing this button here, this one becomes green. And this is also yellow because it can be executed, but it wasn't yet. So I will also execute the Median filter. You can look at results of nodes by opening the viewer. Yeah, so I see here the image viewer of the Median filter. And I can maybe also open the viewer of the image reader. And so here you see the result images of these two steps. So after the Median filter, thresholding is the next step. Enter what I want to do here, and I go a bit through the list of operations I have, and I don't want to apply a local threshold, a threshold which is different in different areas of the image. And I also don't want to get several things out. I just want to have a binary decision. So that's the global threshold. What's the next step afterwards? I would now ask in the audience, connected components analysis. And you see here many things with connect, and in the community nodes, in live image processing, there is connected components analysis. And after connected components analysis, the next step would be measuring something in the labels of the image. And so let's search for label. And when I go through this list, I find many interesting things. And the one which looks the most obvious to me is in the category features. So we want to measure features, right? Labeling properties. So I will just put this node here. And by the very end, we want to save our results to a table. So I can now search for save. And I don't find the particular thing. I can search for table and I will find many things. And the correct solution for this particular step is writing an Excel file to this. So if you don't know what to search for, it may take some time to find the right nodes. It's also a matter of trying. But I would say in the very most cases, after entering one or two words which specify what I want to do, I usually find the node I'm looking for. So I will now also connect all them. And you see they all turn from red to yellow because they suddenly can be executed. And you also see that these two were executed already because I showed you. The other ones were not. And we will have a quick look in the configuration for the thresholder because I haven't told the software yet which threshold method to use. So you find here in the pull-down, per default, Huang is selected. I will go for Ozu because I explained to you already how this one works. So I will leave the other nodes as they are for now. But I will change in the Excel writer also where to write the file. That makes sense. Otherwise, you would get an error message here anyway. And I will save to the desktop. Obviously, I did it earlier. And that's why I get an error message here, which tells me that the file already exists and I have to specify that it should be overwritten. Yeah, so I will just save that and then we can execute the whole workflow. And in this case, I was executing the whole workflow by selecting the last node. So usually when the nodes before were not executed yet and I execute this one, it will execute all the others before that. And I will now have a look at my results table. And we see the file is empty. So obviously we still have to configure something. Yeah, and in order to find out what goes wrong in the Naive workflow, so I'm showing you that intentionally actually, we have to go from the left to the right to find out which of the steps actually is not working. So we have a look now here. So obviously there is something coming out of that node, of the median filter node, which looks reasonable, so which makes sense. So let's have a look in the threshold. Also here, the result looks reasonable, and we can just go ahead. Connected components analysis. Also here, the result looks reasonable, and that's why we could go ahead. Labeling properties. So that, I would have expected now a table with measurements, but I haven't configured anything yet. So maybe this node is the problem. I will go into the configuration of this node. And again, what I'm expecting here is something like set measurements in ImageJ, where I can select which features to measure. When I go through this dialogue here, I will come to the conclusion. So I can also here, I can number of dimensions, source, axis, calibration. But what I'm looking for is area or shape descriptors or intensity, right? Stuff like that. And I cannot find it. So obviously the node is wrong. Obviously I was using a node which is not the node I'm actually looking for. So I will delete the node here by pressing the delete key on the keyboard. And I will search again for something that takes connected components analysis results and allows me to do feature extraction. So I will just enter feature. And you find again in the community nodes in Naive Image Processing, you find image features, but we don't want to determine the features of a whole image. We rather want to get the features of segments, of the result of a segmentation, of result of a labeling kind of. So I will now put this node in my workflow, and it also tells me that it's not configured yet. So let's configure this one. And when I go through this list here, I find under features, different features, for example, shape descriptors and segment geometry. And in segment geometry, so I can now here select different features. And when we want to measure the area of objects, that's the number of pixels in this object. We can also here you see circularity, perimeter, and so on, but maybe we just leave it with this one. And it's now warning me that I also have to select something here, or maybe I just unselect this checkbox. So let's execute this one and look in the output what it does. Yeah. And this is what I was kind of expecting. So I see now here the individual segments from my original image in a interesting way of visualizing it. I also can still read the file name where this data originates. And I see here the number of pixels. And this looks actually like something I would like to save as Excel to disk. And so let's execute this one as well. So let's have a look in the results table. And you can see here now, I have here now this column, which corresponds to the area, to the number of pixels for each object. And this is what I wanted to achieve. So you see that it is kind of normal to configure these nodes on the fly. So checking if the results are okay from the left to the right, and then configuring it depending on how you struggle, but doable. Okay. And the next lecture will be about IC. So see you soon.